I feel like talking about an Iron Giant toy today, if you couldn't tell. Yay. Hey guys and gals, I'm here with your video, and if you can tell, we can see the top of the board. That means we're doing something big today, and that is Trendmasters Ultimate Iron Giant toy from 1999. I don't know why I'm covering this now. I looked at it last night and I was like, I want to talk about you. And so here we are. We're going to cover it today. I don't normally focus on packaging, and I do have chapters. So if you want to skip the packaging, just look down below on the timeline. But if you are looking to buy this guy, here is his box, just for reference. Mine is very heavily beat up, but it's better than it was when I got it. So you're going to want to have this front. Ultimate Iron Giant. It's got a Hogarth on the front. Comes to life when he holds Hogarth. Junk food for Iron Giant eat. Guard mode. It does come with 3 AA batteries already installed. If you are getting one sealed, you're probably going to have corrosion. I had this guy sitting for just a few years, and I forgot he had batteries in it, and it was enough to eat through the wires, so I had to patch him up. So just be prepared, and also you're going to want to make sure you have all the accessories. There should be 3 pieces of junk and a little Hogarth figure. You don't need them to do all his features, but if you are buying this, he goes for like $150, sometimes $300. I think it's if that's sealed. I'm not entirely sure. But if you're going to spend the money to get this, make sure you have all of the pieces. Make sure his electronics work. He has lights and sounds. He's got 3 pieces of junk he can eat, and he has Hogarth, who he can also eat. So just keep that in mind if you are looking to get this thing. The box is, you know, it's all right. I've kept it only because it's somewhat vintage at this point. So this is the Iron Giant figure. I have to hold it very, very far back just to focus on everything. We're going to have a lot of camera adjusting at this point. So just brace yourself for it. So he is 20 inches tall, and he's really impressive just to have displayed somewhere. I think his gray coloring is messing up the color balance, so I'll have to kind of tweak that. He is a really nice, kind of medium shade of gray. This is all dark, obviously. It looks a lot darker on camera than it actually is. But if you go to his back, this is where you can store all of his accessories. This little piece opens up. You have Dean's little junk sculpture, which, you know, looks all right. You have a crushed car. Yeah. I'm going to save Hogarth for last because Hogarth is something special entirely. You, of course, have a tractor that has a big chunk bitten out of it. And this is also, that's where you store his batteries. So here are his settings. If you go to A, which is on the left side, that's just his natural play settings. You go to B, that is his guard mode settings. I guess I'll show the guard mode first just to get it out of the way. It's very, very simple. He has a light sensor on his lower abdomen, so we're going to switch that on. And the one kind of downside, you have to have him facing direct light. You need it, otherwise it's not going to work. So if someone walks past... And I think his eyes actually light up. Hungry. But you can kind of see a little bit. But as you can see, so there is still light from my ceiling, but it's not strong enough to trigger the guard mode. You need an actual bright light focused on him to have it work. So you get the idea for the guard mode. We're going to turn that off, turn it into his basic play mode. He has the exact same sounds for guard mode, for play mode, the multiple options for play mode. So I mentioned Hogarth. Okay, he's looking all right. And then you see this big old face. Oh, Hogarth, what's going on with you, buddy? I will say he is painted well, but the sculpt, his head just looks huge. Yeah, so Hogarth has a magnet on him, and you have a couple of options to play with a giant. If you don't have any of the pieces, you don't want to dig out Hogarth, there's a button on his left hand. Which can trigger things. If you want, you can have the giant hold Hogarth. There's a magnet in his right hand. Hungry. Get a little higher. And then there's a mounted point on his shoulder. Now, if you have Hogarth in any of the magnetic pieces, his button, or the giant's button, doesn't work anymore. I don't think you can't really even see it. He's so big. I'm not prepared for this, but he's got a button right there. So, of course, the giant, he comes with junk that he can eat. So you kind of have a couple options. You can either have Hogarth trigger it. You can press the button, open his mouth, and put in a junk piece that he will eat. It goes into his stomach. Or if you're not quick enough, you can. There's a little lever on the back of his head, so you can just say, "Feed me. I'm so hungry. Come in before I want to order." So let's see if I can feed him some more. Let's. Doop. And there is that one. The tractor, I have the hardest time with it. It seems to get stuck almost all the time. So we're going to put you up there. And there you go. Now we fed the giant. He's all full now. So that's really cool. I like it. It is kind of funny to me to have him
hungry.
It's hungry. And then we have, let's see, let's go. Got a nice attacking sound. There we go. We're just going to feed him Hogarth. And yeah, that's really it for his basic play functions. He does have an additional feature. Let me show you his head. He does have the standard Iron Giant kind of good eyes. And then you can actually switch his eyes to have his more attack eyes. Now, there isn't a red filter on that. You're going to get the same light for both eyes, but you can see how that looks. It's not a great effect. I actually tried to take his head apart once to see if I could give it, like, a better LED.
Hogarth, friend.
Because it's very, very dim. It's just, it's not a great LED. But this is a toy that is now 21 years old now. So I can understand if it's not fantastic. So in terms of his articulation, he's got quite a bit. The shoulders can move that far up. He can't move him outwards. He can't do a full 360. One, because he's got that sculpt in, but two, because there's wires going through his arms. So it's the same thing where he does have rotation at the upper bicep, but you can only go so far because they don't want you twisting those wires. So that's there. The elbows have a decent... Stop, giant. have a decent range of movement, but they can't go any far back because the wires. His wrist can rotate, but again, it's got a stopping point, and his fingers can actually move. His thumb can rotate. There's no waist movement. His legs and knees do have ratchets, but the hips on mine aren't very strong. And I'm not sure if that's just over time they've gotten loose, or if it's just that's how it's always been. As long as I've had this toy, this is how it's been. But the legs can go forward, and they hold pretty well there. But when you get them about there, there's that. If I go to the back, they're actually holding for once. Well, there you go. So there's ratchets there. You got some really... nice strong ratchets at his knees. He can rotate at the thigh area. And his ankles have some slight movement, but it's not enough to really affect his articulation. Once you get him standing up, he holds a pose pretty well. But
hungry.
Yes, I know. You just ate. You can't be hungry. You just ate your best friend. You got to stop this. You got a problem. But given how his articulation is, you don't really want to go crazy with the poses. that's not going to work for... Oh, no. Oh no, we lost him. As I was trying to show, you can't get him standing at any kind of, you know, you know what? It doesn't look natural at all, but hey, you can do it. For me, I just leave him standing straight up. I think he looks fine that way. It's nice, it's natural. He's gonna hold the pose pretty well. And yeah, that's ultimately it for this Ultimate Iron Giant. I like it. I like it a lot. And if you have an Iron Giant collection, which let me bring out my guys. Here's the Walmart figure that I reviewed some time ago. Here's the Mondo figure that I have no idea what I'm going to review. One day. Maybe one day. But you can see just how his color, he's not a light gray. He's not a dark gray. But he's kind of in the middle. And he just looks good for your Iron Giant collection. I would get out my little Funko Pop Iron Giant, but you wouldn't be able to see it. He would be way down there. If you are a fan of the Iron Giant, I definitely recommend checking this guy out. He goes for about as much as the actual small action figures that came out with the movie. And as much as I would like to get those, I can't justify the price. $150 for this, I think, is decent considering what all you get and how big he is. The ones that are going for $300, I don't know. Don't do that. He's not worth $300. You could get this guy for way cheaper. But I like the Iron Giant and I like having this guy. But I think that is it for this video, guys and gals. I hope you have enjoyed it somewhat. If you did, you can subscribe to my channel at the top there to see more videos of mine. Be sure to hit that little bell. I've got two of my previous uploads over there. And I also have a Patreon down below and also a YouTube membership where if you sign up, where I have behind the scenes look, upcoming video ideas, occasional bloopers, access to our Discord server, and new emojis to use during our live streams. I hope y'all have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.